Hey guys.
All right, folks, we're here today to check out a Patreon request from this Patrono right here. Ask to check out some Lacuna Coil with Tight Rope. This is a re-recording, remaster, re-something. It's one of those re's.
It's one of the re's.
Yeah, you know, when you have some old material, but you want to give it a facelift and make it a new material, that's what we got here. So, you ready for some Lacuna Coil? It's been a while since we've done any Lacuna Coil on the channel.
I'm ready.
All right. Bidi-boobidi-bobidi.
Bidi-boobidi-bobidi.
Que cosa? Topo Gigio would be super proud of this.
Would Topo Gigio be proud?
Oh, 100%. 100%.
Would Lucatoni be proud?
Oh, I don't know about Lucatoni. Fuck, Lucatoni.
I should do that celebration all the time.
Damn. That's some deep cuts. Lucatoni, wow. I wonder what happened to that douche.
Retired?
No, of course he retired. Yeah. But I wonder what he's up to. I wonder what he's doing.
Enjoying himself.
Maybe he's got a vineyard somewhere. Like, maybe he's got a...
Or OnlyFans.
I see that guy as, like, a vineyard owner.
Really?
Like, tasting some wine.
In Italy?
In Italy. And when people bring him bad wine, he goes like...
You guys are...
No, like, something here is not right. Something here is not right. I don't know. I just picture him doing that.
Or he's doing like a TED talk. And he's like, the mind is like a safe. You just have to open it.
The possibilities are endless.
Are endless. Once you open up your mind.
Yeah, once you open up your mind, you know, the possibilities are endless.
All right. I only just thought of that now, but the thing he does is like he's cranking the fucking, like a safe.
I know. I never thought about that either. I just took it for what it was.
I took it for what it was.
A stupid celebration.
An awesome celebration.
I think it was super stupid. But anyways, unless you were a Roma fan. If you're fan, you're a huge fan of that. So anyhow, Lacuna Coil, Tightrope. Thoughts on this song?
I enjoyed it. It was a good...
Let me break this down. Instead of just asking you for your thoughts, let's talk about the vocal dynamics between those clean vocals and harsh vocals. Because we've tackled that dynamic in other videos and other songs,
yeah.
And we've been very critical in the past, but there's nothing really here to be critical about.
Yeah, no, this is perfect.
So the question I have for you is, why is this perfect, but sometimes bands try to do something similar and it completely misses the mark?
Well, it's because since both set of vocals are so different and the song changes with those vocals, they work really well. But it's just the fluidity of each vocal range. Each vocal range is perfect and there's no sense of one overthrowing the other. They're both balanced, yet having time to show their stuff. So somehow they're able to shine, yet not take the shine away from the other.
I think there's another element that's very important, is that you get the harsh vocals at the beginning, then you bring her vocals while the harsh vocals are still going on, and then he drops out, and then she jumps into the forefront.
Fluidity. That's what it is.
So
it's perfect.
He's in the forefront, she's in the background, and then they change, and then they don't change places, but he drops out, and then she moves into the front. I think that passing of the baton there, that fluidity that exists
between... hand over hand.
Yeah, the movement that exists between moving from one to the next, I think that's what gives the song this perfect ambiance and this perfect movement. Because it does flow with the music that the track has, but I don't think it would flow the same way had them been completely segregated from one another, getting harsh vocals here and then just clean vocals there. You know, harsh vocals here, clean vocals there. So I feel like that dynamic of bringing her in as a backing vocalist and then eventually peeling off the other layer of harsh vocals and letting her become the main center of the attention when it gets to the chorus, I think that's the winning formula in order to balance them out. Plus, both of them are incredible vocalists, so it's not like they have a weak spot that they're starting from. They're already starting from a position of strength. So when you add that flow, the song is glorious, in my humble opinion.
It is.
I really enjoyed the chorus. I thought that everything that happens in the verses kind of helps set up the chorus.
The chorus for this to be this big pedestal.
Yeah, but there's some darkness in that chorus. There's like this, I was going to say a sense of agony, but it's not agony, but there's a little bit of despair in the way the chorus comes across and the way that her clean vocals flow in the chorus that it just makes, it's almost like the weight of the world is on your shoulders when you're listening to that chorus. It's not one of those choruses that you get, for example, in metalcore songs that makes you want to suck your own dick, like massive breakdown and whatever. It's not like that, but you do feel the weight of the world on your shoulders when that chorus hits and you start to kind of like slouch forward because it's just... It has heaviness, but it's not in the sound, it's not in the vocals, it's in the emotion that the track carries. I thought that chorus was absolutely phenomenal. The verses are just a setup for you to get to that point in the song.
Yeah.
And then the fact that the song is not long, just a little bit over the 3-minute
mark. It's a perfect length. It's perfect length for a song like this to really get into your head and then make you want more. Not giving you that sense of being full with the sound.
Yeah, because not only the chorus is memorable... Not necessarily from a lyrical content,
more
but how
melody.
More of a melody and how it makes you feel. But then the whole song becomes memorable because of its length, it's short, it's easy to remember, it's easy for you to see all the different momentums that exist within the song. Everything comes together perfectly and packed together perfectly to make the song really jump out and for you to say, wow, this is a great track. Great track sound-wise, great track vocally. I just really enjoyed a song like this. It's just... It has all the right pieces in all the right places. That's my personal take on it. Do you agree?
I agree.
Anything else you want to add?
No, I think we've kind of gone with it. I just wanted to say that, you know, the song... I agree fully with what you said up with the song, the fluidity of the vocals and everything, but that just goes to kind of tell people when you have a male and a female vocalist, there are ways to fuck up, but there's also ways to get something like this.
Yeah, when they know what they're doing, they know their limits and they know their ranges and they know what they can get out of each other. Exactly. And it's not about egos. It's not about who leads and who follows. It's about the end product and how can we give everything that we can to the song. I think when you have that in your mind, you're always going to put something forward that's going to be worth listening to.
Yeah.
Two things I want to just quickly say before we go on this video. One thing is that chorus, maybe more than the vocals, maybe more than the sound, but the melody and the atmosphere that chorus creates kind of reminds me of Evanescence. There was some Amy Lee vibes in that chorus.
Yeah, that chorus, yeah. Evanescence, you know,
That's
a good one, yeah.
There was a little bit of an Evanescence aroma in that chorus. Like I said, vocally, sometimes the tones were similar, but more in terms of the mood. That weight of the world on your shoulders is such an Evanescence element, such an Evanescence piece of their sound and their existence. I just felt like it was there. There was a little bit of a secret nod to Evanescence in that chorus. And the second thing I want to quickly say is that this is one of the bands that I've never seen live, and I'm dying to kind of like
check that off the bucket list.
I need to see Lacuna Coil live. Hopefully next time they're in Toronto, I have the opportunity to see them. The last time they were in Toronto, we were at another show on that same day, so we weren't able to see them. But I definitely want to make sure I'm able to check that off of my bucket list, seeing these guys live. So Lacuna Coil, a band to remember. I just... Bibbidi-bobbidi.
Che cosa?
Exactly. I gotta see these guys. All right, guys, let us know your thoughts in the comment section. Hit us up. Thoughts on the video, song, band. Have you seen them live? What was great about it? What was magnificent about it? Use the comment section. We'll see you all in the next video.
See ya.